everyone. In last period, we complete our first lesson. I told you, you can complete your exercise. I think everyone can complete it. Today, now we start work and energy, our second lesson, very important lesson. And everyone open your books and then only you can get all these concepts related to this lesson. I think everyone complete the first lesson exercise. Now, after some time, I will give you a paper depending upon first lesson. So, that also you can solve it. Okay, come back to our second lesson, work and energy. I think everyone open the books on page number 18. In this lesson, we can discuss about the work, energy, mechanical energy, law of conservation of energy and free fall. Means minimum 5 points, 5 concepts we can discuss in this lesson. Before we start the lesson, they gave you some pictures and they say observe it. Okay, pictures minimum 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 pictures and they doing something they gave you and you can observe it and what you see, what is your observation, you can discuss it in your classroom. But now it is not possible, so I will told you what is that. When you see something is in your mind, you can discuss it like that. Now I only told you what is that. First picture of girl can study. She can do in her homework. Okay, like you, when you go to home, you also like that. You can bring your homework. She sit on the earth and she can complete their homework. Second, the boy can stand only and doing something with the hand. The girl, third picture, the girl sit and see the TV, remote is in her hand only. And last, one man can carry out something from one place to the another. Miss, this is the pictures, what they doing, I will discuss with you. When you are here, we can discuss it in the classroom, but now it is not possible, so I will explain you. So depending upon these pictures, what they gave you, some questions they gave you, okay. Can you tell, okay, which are they? In which of the pictures above has work been done? We see the pictures, we discuss the pictures, okay. Something is in your mind when we see the pictures. So they ask first question, which have doing the work? As per your contribution of thinking, who doing work? I told you, as per our thinking, all are doing works. But when we go scientifically through physics, okay, who will be done the work? A last man who carry out something from one place to another, that person are doing work. Why? These two considerations will be there. Which consideration? First I told you, all are doing work. But related to science, in the physics, only the last man can do the work. Why it is, I will explain you further. Next question, from scientific point of view, when do we say that no work was done? They gave you another question. When you can say it, that work cannot done. Work means what? Work means we doing something. Means first one, first girl can do something, yes, she doing homework. Second man also doing something with their hands. Third girl also doing something, he see the TV. And last man also something doing. Something you can do means not a work. Work means what then? It is different from others. Only you can sit and doing something. I will stand here and giving lecture. No, not doing work. Then when we can do the work in scientific way? The work can done when we apply the force to others or to the other objects and displacement can done, then only work can do like a science. Means science says that, physics says that, when work done, when force is there and displacement occur, then only work can done. Then this concept when we apply on these four pictures, what we say? Only the last man can do the work because that man can carry something, means applying force on that, and he can change the position from one place to the other, means displacement occur. That man can go from one place other. So very important, related to science, related to physics, force is equal to what? Sorry, work is equal to what? Force into displacement. Don't forget, scientific point of view, work can done with the force and displacement. So it is very important, when we doing work means we apply force with respect to displacement, we change the place. So last man, which is given in your pictures, can doing work because that man carried out something with applying force and can change the position. Remaining three are, they cannot change their position. They cannot apply the force. First girl, she doing homework. She applying force? No. Only mental work can do. She sit as it is. She cannot change their position. Then the TV girl, she can do work? No. Scientific view, when we see, through scientific view, that third girl which see the TV cannot doing work because she cannot change the position and force cannot apply. So remaining three cannot doing work, only the last man can do the work. Okay, understood? Okay, then we go further. What we see? Any mental or physical activity referred as work? No. When only the force and displacement occur, then only we can say work can done. To do work, what we require? We know now, we work, we want force, we want displacement. But to doing work, something is required. What that? We require energy. To apply force, we require energy. Means to pull something, to push something, we require energy. And energy, from where we get? Which we eat in the morning, in the evening. Means from the morning to the evening, which we eat. From that food, we get nutrients. And from that nutrients, we get energy. And all that energy, we can gain for doing work. We can use it for doing work. When we are empty stomach, we have empty stomach, we cannot do something or some anything. We do it. We don't have capacity to do something. But when we have full stomach, then we do something. We go to on ground, we play. We pull something, we push something. But stomach is empty, we sleep. We are go into the sleeping mode. So our food is also important. When we eat food, we get nutrients, and we get nutrients, we get energy, and we get energy, then we do work. Okay, like our father, like our mother, they doing jobs, but they eat something, they get tippings to with us for doing work. So it is very important. Then next one, work definition in scientific view. This is a equation. Work is equal to force into displacement. But definition is also important. Definition. On the equation, you can clearly write the definition. What is definition? Work is said to be done when force is applied and object causes displacement. Then it is called work done. From the equation, definition is clear. What is it? Work done is said to be when force is applied and the object causes displacement, means it goes from one place to another. This is work in scientific view. Then work is equal to force into displacement. It is an equation. Then what we see? Different types of forces. They gave you, can you recall? What the question? What are the different types of forces and their examples they want? Now you know, work want, force want, displacement want. So different types of forces, even you know, with respect to their examples, then you can do work. First we discuss about the types of forces. Only this is introduction. discussion. On this discussion, your next points are depends. They are interrelated. So we can discuss it. When you know about what means what, when you know about displacement, when you know about types of forces with their example, then you can get all remaining concepts related to this. Okay. So we can discuss it. What is it? Different types of forces and their examples. First, very important force is gravitational force. First, I will write the forces, then we discuss about that. First is gravitational force. Second, electrical force. Third, magnetic force. And next, frictional force. Okay. Number of forces will be there. I write minimum 4. Okay, which are related with you only. So we can discuss gravitational force. It is related to gravity. When gravity is present, we can stop, we can stand here. So it applies with the earth and human being. Electrical force, it is related to electricity. When electricity is there, electric force will be there. So electrical force is very important. Magnetic force, related to magnets, north south poles will be there. Same force attracts opposite force, opposites. Frictional force, it is related to the surface. When we place the book on the table, it goes outside. So it is frictional force between the book and the table. So these types of forces are present, so we can do our works. This number of forces can be, but only I will discuss it with 4 only. They are related to your daily life. Gravitational force is everywhere. Where you go, it is present. So we can stand, so we can go here and there, so we can play. Gravitational force is very important to our life. Electrical force is also important. Electricity is important. And magnetic force, everyone know magnets, how they are important. So these forces are our daily, they are related to our daily life. So I will discuss it. These forces cannot change, they cannot destroyed from our life. It will be destroyed, then our life stop. So all these types of forces are important, but remaining part, how they are important with our daily life, their examples, we can discuss it in our next lecture. You can read all that points in your home and come back to the next lecture. Up to this, you can get 99%, I think. So we can stop here. Thank you all.